we're back. Joining us is Tony Chennault from the hit digital TV show, Oldhead, the series, to chat about the influences and the story behind the creation of the show.
Hey, Tony.
Welcome,
how are you,
Tony.
Man?
Thanks for having me.
What's going on? Good handshake. I like it. I like it. Tell me what Oldhead is. I'm not familiar.
So Oldhead is a story that I created back in 2014 after graduating from Villanova University. So I created Oldhead to kind of shed light on some of the issues that go on in the inner cities and talk about the importance of having an Oldhead. I'm someone who didn't have a father in their life growing up, but I had neighborhood Oldheads, whether it's mentors, sports coaches that kind of led me down the right path to success. And it's more like kind of like a call to action to bring back the right mentors to the community.
So Tony, wow. I have watched your video countless times. Yes. I can't stop watching your video. And by the way, guys, take a look at his video. It's amazing. It's an amazing story, what you went through. Mm-hmm. And it touched me really deeply.
Yes.
So tell our viewers exactly what happened, what transpired on your way to becoming an NBA star, right?
So before I became this filmmaker, director, I had big aspirations of playing in the NBA. I grew up playing basketball, but I had some personal tragedies. I lost my brother, Mike, who was like a father figure in my life, as an innocent bystander in a shooting back in 2012. Then a year later, my mom died in 2013. She had a seizure. So those two incidents kind of just made my whole trajectory of life just changed drastically to let me know that life is bigger than sports, and I wanted to do something that was more meaningful, more impactful, that I could leave behind a legacy that when I'm long gone, that my work would stand the test of time.
Wow.
And do you write the show yourself?
Yes, I'm one of the writers.
Wow.
So we have a group of five writers that write the show. They all come from different perspective of life, which is great for the show, and yeah.
So you started Oldhead in what year you started?
2014 we started.
So 2014, so you've been doing it ever since then?
Yes, we've been doing it ever since then, and we have other projects we're working on too as well. We have a feature film that we're going to be shooting this summer that we're really excited about.
Wow.
Wow.
And we want to be a big-time film company. We plan to bring a lot of big-time productions to Philadelphia.
Are you looking to be an old head for the younger generation?
Well, I consider myself an old head in the sense that I'm somebody that younger kids in my community seek out information from.
Yeah.
And just using my life as a testament that, we're much more than your circumstances, to dream bigger than your circumstances, that, I come from a place where one decision or mistake could cost you your life or freedom, but having the ability to move past that and doing something positive, I think young people see that as a positive influence in their life.
So why do you think there's such a disconnect between the young kids and the adults?
I just think sometimes younger kids don't feel like hip, meaning it's cool how older people may present information to them, mm-hmm. but they see somebody who's actually cool and doing something really fun and dope, which is mean cool,
right.
I think they take heed to the information and they see that in myself.
I know, I sort of wish schooling happened later in life, because I would have paid more attention in my 20s than I ever did in my teens, and
right.
probably would have been better when I had that maturity.
Yes.
What kind of feedback have you gotten? Like, what's your, the best story you've ever gotten from a fan of Oldhead?
Well, I mean, we went to a juvenile detention center about a year ago, and some of these kids in their teenage years are, facing serious charges, and some of these kids just were really moved by the story, because it's a story that they can resonate with. It's something
True.
Authentic to them, and through these characters, they see themselves as people they know in their community.
Right.
Wow. I mean, it's just amazing. Just amazing how you're able to connect with them. That's the amazing part. That's what baffles me, because sometimes it's so hard, right? So what I would like for you to do, and we talked about this before, is that I want you to look at the camera over there, and I want you to talk to them again. Show us a little bit of that connection that you have
Absolutely.
With the kids.
Well, like I said, Oldhead series, our third season is coming out. This is much more than a film project. It's a project that's bringing people together from all walks of life. It's something that speaks authentically to people all across, the country, specifically in the inner cities of America. Make sure you guys subscribe to our YouTube page, Oldhead the Series, and follow us on Instagram, Oldhead PDX. Thank you.
Wow. Oh, I'm touched.
That was amazing.
Where do you see the series going? Where do you want it to launch off to?
That's a great question. I just want to keep growing. I want to keep growing with the actors. I want to keep growing with the people I'm working with, and I think sky's the limit. I think Oldhead is not a Philadelphia thing. It's a universal thing, and I want to bring it to other cities, and that's our plan.
You said you shot in New York City, right?
Yes, we shot.
All right, so you're expanding.
Of course.
So New York City, we added a New York City storyline, and then for season 4, we plan to add Atlanta, Atlantic City one as well, too.
I think we see a star here.
I think we do.
I think we see a star in the making here.
Before we go, I just want to know, because you're such a light for, you know, the younger generation, what's the best piece of advice you have for them?
Just follow your heart. My mom always should have told me, like, just follow your heart. If your heart's involved in what you're doing, no matter what the adversity or obstacles going to be in your way, you're going to find a way to fight through it.
Wow. Tony.
Tony, thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Good luck to you.
Thank
you.
That is so magical.
Okay.
Stay with us. After the break, we have an expert who will be giving us the top five things that everyone needs to know before starting a business. So all of you entrepreneurs out there, get ready to take notes.